Welcome back. In front of me, I have one, two, three trinket boxes. And one by one, I'd like to open them up and show you what's inside. I'd like to go in the order in which the boxes were, I guess, in the order in which I received them. I believe I've had this one the longest. So I'm gonna adjust the camera angle a little bit and we'll start with this one. This does indeed say peas on it. P-E-A-S. It was made by a very good friend of mine in high school. We didn't go to high school together, but we went to class together, and she befriended another girl at her high school that she said we should get together and meet one day. And in anticipation of the event, I said, I think we're gonna go together like peas, carrots, the butter you cook it in. So that's how we got those nicknames. And so Butter made Carrots and I each a box like this that we both still have. And so here's my cluster of peas handle. Three of us were going to meet. We were going to meet up to see The Beach. It was a 2000 film directed by Danny Boyle, starring Leonardo DiCaprio. I mention that because this bookmark is named Richard, because I bought him when I bought the book of The Beach by Alex Garland. It's a little clip bookmark. So yeah, it's my bookmark named Richard. And this is just kind of a random bookmark. This is in here because I like to try to remember where my black Sharpie is. Also, as many scrunchies and clips as I have, I like to try to keep one in here so that I know where one is. A random glue stick. Some dice, two 20-sided, one 8-sided, these are just kind of random, but sometimes I like to randomize things, so it's good to have a different kind of dice around. Oh, that was the last item in the box, so I'll put these back in. This bookmark. she painted the clouds is if I'm accidentally putting the lid on backwards, I can tell because the clouds don't match up. It's like this all the way around. Used to belong to my cousin, and she gave it to me. It's made in India. Keep mostly jewelry items in here. It has a red crushed velvet interior. See what we have here. There's this little box given to me by my uncle. One of my uncles. This is an earring that's missing its partner. Keep it in here in case I find it. These little darlings. Were given to me by my dad on, I think, like my 9th birthday. And honestly, they're some of my favorite earrings. I just like how delicate and pink they are. And when I'm feeling feminine enough to want to put in earrings, they do the trick for me. The same cousin that used to own this jewelry box also owned this bracelet. It's just an elastic bead bracelet. And it was one of those kind of borrowed it till I forgot to return it situations, but I don't think she misses it too much. Was given to me by a coworker from when I worked at a department store. Her name's Alejandra. And she was, a very comforting kind of mother figure. This was the first, city I lived in away from home, so she was, I liked having an older woman to kind of, talk to and look up to while I was stressing out about stuff. So I get to think of her whenever I see this bracelet. Another beaded bracelet. Oops. I just picked this up at some kind of shop. And I believe I picked this one up at a world market. It's kind of not very attractive, really, because, you know, it's stretched out. You can just see the plain, stringy stuff underneath a bit much. But sometimes I like the way it dangles off my wrist. These are hematite. These are just some kind of glass, abstract, heart-like shapes with bubbles in them. I like these. These are actually some more of my favorite earrings, too. I really like the color of these. Check my framing. It's alright. These were given to me by the same friend who made my peeves box from before. And then this is the last pair of earrings are just kind of a plain. Square. This is an item I've had since very young. It was given to me by my grandmother. It's just a mouse pin. I like the delicate tail. Came from my grandmother on my mom's side, and these came from my grandmother on my dad's side. They're the little screw-on type of earrings that screw onto your lobe, and they're little porcelain china doll shoes, sort of. Not sure. I don't really wear them. Because I don't like wearing this type of earring, but I just like them. There's just some random other gold angel earrings. I don't really, just kind of think they maybe came from a great aunt, so probably wanted to keep them for sentimental reasons. Let's see what's down here. Mostly down here are watches that are either broken or need batteries. This is, I enjoyed this one for a while. It's kind of, the strap on it's kind of old, so I don't know. But it's Joan Rivers Classics. My mom got it off QVC. I like the east-west facing. Or clock face, watch face. A more delicate watch that also needs a battery. The shiny stuff is marcasite. Ever had. My parents gave it to me when I was really young. I keep it in this bag because it's, you know, quite old, so the stuff's flaking off. Oops. This is a random choker I had gotten for Halloween this year. I didn't go as anything in particular. I just wanted to look unrecognizable. This was part of that. And then I also got these feather earrings. From the Halloween store. I like them. I could see myself wearing them other times, but then again, not really. Depends on how my hair is looking. I might hide it sometimes. Now this is a very special butter knife. So you remember when I told you about how how carrots, butter, and I kind of came together around the time of the movie The Beach coming out? Well, we were so inspired by the movie that we decided to have a friendship ritual and brand ourselves, like in the scene. I don't know if anybody's seen the movie, but there's the anyway, the scene where they brand the newcomers to the island. Now, we didn't do the whole soot bit, but we put this in the embers of a bonfire that had been going, so we got it nice and hot and sprayed it with some rubbing alcohol to kind of sterilize it, and I branded carrots, and then carrots branded butter, and then butter branded me. So, and since it took place in my backyard, I guess that's why I got to keep the knife. but we all got to keep the marks. Mm-hmm. It was a big night for us because we were all, very like honor roll students. We didn't sneak out of the house or anything like that. Very good teenage girls. And this was something we just felt really free doing this with each other. And we actually celebrated the anniversary of that each year and called it Tet. again, it's kind of referring to a little bit of the culture in the movie, but in our case, Tet stood for togetherness equals trust. And we would fill up super soakers with water and have water gun riot. Lots of fun. And I might change the camera angle again since the depth of the last box is a little different. Here's the last box. Hinges, I guess we call those. Got this on a birthday a few years back. One of the tassels has fallen off of this drawstring bag. These are some different crystals and stones in here. I like the ornaments. this? I'm not sure what kind of incense it holds. I don't remember where it came from. I think it maybe came in an incense set. You can see the soot marks inside. A cone is a bit big to fit in there, but I'm sure there was some kind of little incense piece. Some root chakra oil you get from those healing shops. I don't remember what kind of oils are in here and all, what kind of stones. I think there might be some red tiger's eye and garnet in here. I just like the cuteness of the bottle too, you know. This is the baby from a king cake, although it was never put inside the king cake. You know. So I just kept it as a souvenir. I think. Another little box. When I was working in a very busy coffee shop in Austin, there was a gentleman who worked across the street who he was a regular, and one day he gave me this little pocket Buddha. And I remember it was my bring. I would keep it in my pocket for work as a specific kind of stay calm at work charm. I always liked it because it reminded me of the kindness of a stranger. Because, you know, I think I knew the fella's first name at the time, but still, we were very not too well acquainted, and so it's just, I don't know, it helped with some of my social anxiety issues I was having. It's a pocket totem. It's an owl made of blue soda light. Came with this card. Shows where I believe blue soda light is supposed to help with creativity, and the shape of the owl with vision. So creative vision. some scented burning oils in the bubble wraps here. And now I shall gracefully insert a clip of me unwrapping these scented oils carefully from bubble wrap, this time without a plane flying overhead. So spiritual power. This is my favorite of the oils. Another plane. Rude. Anyway, rain, more fresh kind of scent. This is probably my favorite stone in the bag, carnelian. Whispering often refers to it as being a very powerful stone, and it is. I don't use crystal grids, although I'd like to give it a try. But I like to have them around, them as in a few crystals, just to ponder with and meditate with every now and then. This is a rose quartz. Amazonite. Red jasper. Amandine garnet. It's an opaque type of garnet. Yeah. I like it. It's actually one of my, it's become one of my preferred stones, more for how it looks. I haven't really, I guess worked with its properties too much, but I just like the reddish, deep, chocolatey kind. Yeah, this is the black jet. Balance them right there. And this is a pyramid of tourmalinated quartz. Bloodstone. It's got the flecks of red jasper in it. Hematite. I believe this is rutilated quartz. It's got a couple of gold strands, but not nearly as many as black strands in the tourmalinated. This is fluorite. It's mostly clear. It's got some purple and some green in it. This is a double terminated quartz. Double terminated refers to the fact that it has two points on each, or a point on each end. Oops. This is a tiny amethyst cluster. An opaque emerald, which looks quite different from the translucent kind. Tiger's eye. It's a very pretty one. another tiny pink quartz. Or rose quartz, rather. And this fluorite. And a quartz skull. Empty. I'm gonna go ahead and put them back in. Get this troublesome fluorite first. For watching, if you made it this far, as in if you didn't get too bored. I was happy for the opportunity to share a little stuff about me. Thank you. next time.